But first, while we have him here, let's talk about Dan's two favorite things. PC games and Final Fantasy.
Well, one out of two, I bet.
Final Fantasy 15 coming to PC March 6th, and that's the same day the Royal Edition will also come to consoles, cool. Which is a further expanded version of the original Final Fantasy 15.
You know what they call it in France?
In addition to the base game, and all I already regret. And now it's time for Casey. In addition to the base game and all current season pass content, which includes character-specific episodes, Gladiolus, Prompto, and Ignis, as well as the multiplayer Comrades expansion, both editions will feature all updates to the game. It also includes two new areas of the map, a new boat, a new accessory, a first-person mode.
Some of those things aren't as big as the other things.
But it's like all of this, all this together. Like,
what about the
wasn't
game?
In the original game.
I know. What about VR fishing?
I don't think that's included.
But there's
in this.
Fishing. That's there's separate. Non-VR fishing.
I mean, there's just regular
fishing.
Yeah,
I play the non-VR fishing. It's pretty good.
So this is all out on in the PC version, which is the first time PC players will get to play. The Royal Edition, for everyone else, is going to be $20. All the extra stuff is $20 for people who already own the game.
Oh. Any console?
Yeah.
Like to upgrade,
to upgrade your
PC
current.
Thing.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
Well, some commenters were expressing their frustration that, like, when you buy the game on day one, you don't get the full game.
Oh, yeah. You know? Well, that has been definitely the case for that game.
I mean, this
because
is
because they changed chapters in it.
It's 2018. That game is a 2016 game. It's now in its second year of life. And, like, this is coming up on because they've promised they're not even done. Like,
and this is in addition to the season pass stuff.
Yeah. So we're in a second season pass territory now. And, like, this is getting up there with, like, Borderlands 2 for, like, games that, in my opinion, like, single player games that aren't, like, you know, MMO or Division or something like that have had the most continued, like, post-launch support in terms of big story patches and just small little things like first-person mode and remixing content and changing things. It were in almost unprecedented territory.
I'd say like the Mass Effect games had more, and except for Andromeda, granted. the prior Mass Effect games had a regular infusion of DLC, like story DLC, for a couple of years.
Yeah. But like this one added, like, just a patch would come out and like, hey, you can drive your car off-road now.
Yeah.
And it's like, was anybody asking for that? Like, it's just like these bizarre,
it
like this bizarre
weird.
Mismatch of like story DLC that's filling in gaps in the story. You know, new side quests, new functionality, new areas. Like, it's crazy to me.
It is. It's crazy to me too. Like, I have Final Fantasy 15, but I don't have all this stuff, and I don't have the season pass stuff. So it's like, if I revisit that game in 5-10 years, I don't have the full thing, right? I just have like the initial chunk of it.
Yes.
It's just different. It's weird.
Yeah.
Weird times.
You always run into that I didn't get the full game thing, which to me rings as like an argument against ongoing development, ongoing support, because you're like, okay, which I don't know. I it's like, yes, obviously I want the best quality game.
I can
at
see
launch,
waiting 2 years.
Oh, absolutely. There's nothing wrong.
It's a valid
with
question. Yeah. It's right. Like, what, maybe we are getting to a time when there are only a few select games you gotta have on day one.
It does become like that choice. Assassin's Creed is another really wonderful example where very meaty, meaningful DLC is coming out now, sort of when that game's moment is kind of past. Like, you don't hear as many people talking about Assassin's Creed Origins. And big DLC that raises the level cap, unlocks new areas of the map, new bosses. And I played 6 or 8 hours of that game in the fall and kind of fell off it. I liked it, but, you know, just fell off. And now it puts you in a little bit of an awkward spot where, like, when is the right time to play a game? Like, last fall was arguably, like, the worst time to play Final Fantasy. Like, you missed the boat on getting to be a part of the
literally
conversation. But you also missed the boat on, like, well, you don't get the complete, like, everything. Just give me all the content and let me explore it all at once.
That's just a small taste of what we've got in store for you in this week's episode of Gamescoop. For the full episode, head over to youtube.com/gamescoop and be sure to subscribe.